A report on the conservation of Hainan gibbon was released on Sunday during two press conferences held simultaneously at the 7th World Conservation Congress in French port city of Marseille and also in China's Hainan province. The report, titled The Hainan Gibbon Case Study, Effectively Saving a Critically Endangered Species, was written by 15 experts from 11 organizations from all over the world. The report shows how the Hainan gibbons have increased from as few as 7 to 9 in the 1980s to 35 individuals today, thanks to efficient protection by the Chinese central to local governments and a combined effort by Chinese and international scientists and conservation communities.
The case of the Hainan gibbon is very special. One could say virtually unique, but very special because of the extremely low number. I mean, this species should be extinct, and it's not. And why is that? It's because really enlightened leadership, international cooperation of experts who really care, and then it's the unique way that the leadership enlisted the local community, and the local community wanted to do it. It's their given. So by doing these several distinct elements, this species came back from the brink of extinction. They're breeding strong now. Just in the last 15 years, they've gone from 2 breeding groups to 5 breeding groups. That's actually quite remarkable.
Hainan gibbon is the most endangered of all the gibbons and is the world's rarest primate. It is endemic to the island of Hainan and was dubbed as the giant panda of Hainan. It is currently found only in a single reserve, the Bawangling Nature Reserve, which is now part of the Hainan Tropical Rainforest National Park.
There's a big picture story going on in China with nature conservation, which is a real modern-day global example of how you have to go about